Hello, pupils. Hello, pupils. Well, welcome to another edition of our geometry class. And today we shall be looking at the properties of 2D and 3D shapes. And the properties under consideration include vertices, faces, and edges. Vertex. What is a vertex? A vertex is a single point. It joins edges together in a shape. The plural of vertex is vertices, as it is shown in the video. The arrow points in the direction of the vertices, while the number shows the number of vertices that you have in this shape. As you can see, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 vertices. So there are 4 vertices in a rectangle. The second property under consideration is the edges. What are edges? What is an edge? An edge is a line segment on the boundary of a shape joining one vertex corner point to another. An edge is the line between two corners or surfaces. The line where two faces meet is called an edge, and the edges are shown in number. So you can see there are 4 edges, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then the third property is the faces or the face. Every plane shape has faces enclosed between lines. It is the flat or curved part of a plane shape, as shown below. In a triangle, we have just a single face. Example 1. How many faces, edges, and vertices has a triangle? Then the answer. Number of faces or face of a triangle is 1. The number of edges of the triangle is 3, while the number of vertices of the triangle is 3. The shape shown is the shape of a 3D shape. The triangle was a 2D shape. So how many faces, edges, and vertices has a cube? Answer. Number of faces of the cube equals 6. The number of edges of a cube equals 12, while the number of vertices of a cube equals 8. So we can easily identify these properties in our shapes. Assignments. Complete the table below. Count the number of faces, edges, and vertices as shown. So the shapes are square, rectangle, triangle, circle, cuboid, cube. So letter F represents the number of faces in each of these shapes, the number of edges, vertices. Then we can work with the expression F plus E minus V. We add the number of edges to the faces, then we deduct the number of vertices to get our answer for that column. Assignment number 2 shows a practical demonstration of how to identify the real object. So that is the vertex, each vertex, then we have vertices in our shape, that's the curtain, then that shows the face, and that's the number of faces, that's the edge. Edge. So for the examples we are going to give, it's better to look at your environment, identify the shapes, count the number of these properties. So for this shape, there are 12 edges, 8 edges, and 8 vertices, then 6 faces.